illegal in United States, and till recently it was illegal in Andhra Pradesh. Later on, the government gave the permission and it promotes it and it regulates it. Meaning giving the permission, promotion and regulation to alcoholism, directly or indirectly. This is the meaning of the word legalization. Another example I could give, share market. Earlier share market was not at all there. But later on, government, when it came into the market, in the society, it gave permission to it, it promoted, as well as it regulates it. That is legalization. Legalization has great significance. Great significance. There are many things in our society which we can't legalize. But they are very good for the common people. But we can't legalize that. For example, the paramedic staff working in the government hospitals. These people who are working for 20 years, 25 years, 30 years, they are so well trained in their respective departments that they can beat any UG, undergraduate medico, or PG, postgraduate medico, in practice. But that doesn't mean that Medical Council of India gives the permission to these paramedics to practice. It can't be given to them. Why? Because if it be legalized, it has great impact on the society. No one will try to become a full doctor or a postgraduate doctor, MBBS or MD. Rather, they will become the paramedics, take the permission and start the practice. So legalization has always been of great significance. What actually we should discuss is whether this activity of homosexuality should be decriminalized or not. This is the bone of contention, that whether it should be decriminalized or not. Today, we will first discuss whether it should be decriminalized or not, then we will discuss whether it should be legalized or not. First, we will discuss whether beer should be available in the market as a permissible product or not. Then we will discuss whether whiskey should be permissible or not. We will analyze from both the sides the impact of beer on the society. If that is okay, then we will talk about whiskey. But if the beer itself is a problem in the society, then thinking of whiskey is nothing but inviting a disaster. First, we will analyze the religious aspect, because the topic demands, in the light of religion and modern science. Today, due to the time constraint, I'll be discussing only three major religions which are dominating in the world. The first, Christianity, next Hinduism, next Islam. These three religions are having around more than 4.5 billion followers around the globe, or approximately 4.5 billion. And these three religions are dominant religions in almost 85 to 90% of the world. So if these three communities understand our talk in the right perspective, then there is a surety that we can solve this issue. As Prince said, let us not call it a problem at the starting point of our talk. At the end, you can take the decision what it is. But I will call it an issue. So, to solve this issue, we need to understand this in both religious perspective and scientific perspective. First, let us analyze homosexuality in Hinduism. Hinduism is not a basically religion, but rather it is a geographical term. According to Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, the first Prime Minister of modern India, he writes in his book, Discovery of India, on page number 74, that the word Hindu was given by Arab travelers to the people residing beside the river Indus. Later on, the word Hindu, the misnomer of it, become Hindus. Then from Hindus, Hinduism come into the market. The first time this word Hinduism was used in 1835 by a British author to describe a community with various religious festivals and beliefs. The real term should be Vedantist, meaning the people who believe in Vedas. The religious scripture of Hindus are Vedas, Upanishad, Puranas, then they have Itihasas like Ramayana and Bhagavad Gita, and they have Brahmanas, then they have Manusmritis, etc., etc. If you analyze the religious scripture of Hindus regarding the act of homosexuality, you will find at various places the act of lesbianism as well as homosexuality condemned. Prince Manvendra Singh Gohil, being a Hindu, I know that he is a scholar, as he had claimed, of Hinduism, could easily understand when I will refer to the references and the verses from the religious scriptures of Hinduism. If you read the Hindu religious scripture Manusmriti, it's mentioned in chapter 8, verse number 367, chapter 8, verse number 369, chapter 8, verse number 370, as well as in Manusmriti, chapter 11, verse 174. It's also mentioned in Arthashastra, book number 4, chapter number 13, verse number 379. The verse which continues in Manusmriti is, if any damsel spoils another damsel, then the punishment for this particular act is that her two fingers should be cut off, her head should be shaven off, and she should be debarred from the city. The same case with the men who spoils or do this act with another man, indicating that anyone involved in the act of homosexuality should be condemned and they should face the punishment given by Arthashastra and the Manusmriti. This clearly indicates that the religious scriptures of Hinduism is completely against the act of homosexuality. They are completely against the act of sodomy. They are against gayism. They are against lesbianism. If you analyze Christianity, according to Oxford Dictionary, Christianity means a religion which believes in Jesus, peace be upon him, as the Son of God Almighty. It also means that salvation through Jesus Christ. And the religious scriptures of Christianity is the Holy Bible. We have various types of Bibles in the market, like King James Version, Roman Catholic Version, Revised Standard Version, etc., etc. If you refer to the religious scriptures of Christianity, it also tells you the same story, that homosexuality is condemned and it is a punishable act. It is nothing but an act which invites severe punishment from God Almighty. If you refer to the Christian religious scriptures, that is the Holy Bible, it's mentioned in book of Ezekiel, chapter 16, verse 49 and 50. It's mentioned in book of Genesis, chapter 19, verse 3 to 5. It's mentioned in book of Jude, chapter 1, verse 7. It's also mentioned in book of Leviticus, chapter 18, verse 22. All these quotations which I am giving refers to the punishment and condemnation of homosexual activity. Book of Leviticus, chapter 18, verse 22 says that you should not sleep with a man as you sleep with a woman. Book of Genesis, chapter 19, verse 4 to 8 says, it gives the complete story of the people of Lot, peace be upon him. It gives you the complete picture what happens to the community of Lot, peace be upon him. When the community demands this activity from Lot and did not heed to the commands given by God Almighty and his messenger Lot, peace be upon him, then God had sent a severe chastisement to this community. in the form of raining of the brick stones and turning the city upside down. These verses from the Bible